Hi, welcome to a SolidWorks 2018-19 video tutorial. I want to do the screw strap exercise with solids now in SolidWorks. So let's have fun with SolidWorks. So let's start with a sketch on the front plane. Yes. And that might look something like this. Okay, add dimensions and maybe one constraint, so this point and that one should be aligned vertical. Now add dimensions from that point up to that line, 14.5. This distance might be 29.9. This length should be 30. That one 42.5. And that distance should be 82.5. Let's add two fillets with 50 mm, one here, one over there. Confirm. Finish that sketch, or just finish this one. Finish that sketch. Let's make an extrude with that sketch, and of course, yes, it should be mid-plane and it should be 70 mm, and you could go for a thin feature in one direction. Yes, that's the right direction, and this should be 7.5, and confirm. Now the next sketch should be on the top plane. That would be this one. So it turned it around. That's interesting. Okay, let's convert identities. This one, that one, and this one. Let's take a look if these are the correct ones. Yes, confirm. And let's make these elements just for construction. Confirm. Let's go to the top view. Let's see if that top view is the same as this one. So let's turn around. Interesting. Okay, and that might look something like this. Go there, go over here, go over there. Up, okay. Let's add dimensions on this one. This should be 65, that should be 45. And align on the center or midpoint of that line. So this point should be aligned with that one. Horizontal. Same here. This point and maybe that one or this one. Again, horizontal. Add fillets, maybe 10 millimeter fillets, one here, one there, here, and there as well. Confirm. And I want to delete that dimension. And they should not be equal. Now let's put this point onto that line. And let's take a closer look. This point onto that one. Okay, undo. And maybe first put this point onto that line. Yeah. Let's take a look. So that went back there. That's like move it over here and put that point onto this line. And now that point right there. Nice. Now for these, so let's go here, put this one on that one, this point onto that one, then move that point back. Okay. Put it right there. Sorry, put it over here, coincident, and that point here, coincident. This point should be on that line, it would be the midpoint, and I need a dimension from this line to that one. And this should be 82.5. Finish that sketch. Let's make another extrude. That sketch. Don't merge the result and make it 40 millimeters. Confirm. So I've got two bodies. This would be the side view body or solid. And that would be the top view solid. I want to make an intersect. So go for a combine. I want to make it common, and this one and that one. Show preview. Confirm. And that's the combined solid. Now another sketch. On the front plane, I wanted this view, and this might look something like this, add dimensions. This should be 20. This should be 32.5. This distance 7, and that one 14.5. Let's put this point onto that one. And leave that sketch. Let's make a revolve. Select the sketch, or first the axis. The axis would be, of course, this one. 360 degrees, but I don't want to merge the result. And confirm. Now, that would be the revolve body. Just revolve. Another sketch on the top plane. And this one, sketch. That's amazing. It's always turning around. I want to convert that edge, not the face, sorry. But the edge here. Confirm. Make this one for construction only. Now I need a rectangle. This would be 40 by 12. And now I want to put that midpoint here onto that midpoint over there. Coincident. Confirm. Leave that sketch. Let's take a look. Another extrude. No, with that sketch, yes. Don't merge. Make it 40 and confirm. This would be the pocket. I will need a copy of this body, the combine. That would be the first intersect. So let's give it a different name. That's the intersect. I need a copy of that intersect. So I go for move copy bodies. I want to copy that intersect. This one, or you could select it over here. And I don't want to translate it at all. I need copy, one copy, and confirm. Yes, no translation. So I got the intersect and a copy of it. And now I want to intersect this body and the pocket. So let's go for another combine. Go for common. And that would be that body move copy and the pocket. And confirm. So it seems it didn't select. Happens now. Okay. So got now a new. That would be the new pocket. Yeah, the name already exists, so go for pocket 2. Okay, now I want to move that pocket 1 millimeter up, so go for move copy bodies, select that pocket 2 body, this one. And move it 1 millimeter, no copy, but move it 1 millimeter in y direction. And confirm. Let's combine this body with that one. So go for another combine. I want to add this one to that one. Confirm. Now I want to remove that face. So go for delete face and see if it works. I want to select that face. Yeah, and it should delete and patch. Confirm. Great. Now let's subtract this one from that one. Go to combine, subtract, target or main body would be that body, and the body to subtract is this one. And confirm. Next, go for a hole wizard. And it should be blind, yes. It should be one with, let's take a look. Yeah, legacy hole, yes. Blind, yes, but the type would be countersunk, or is it counterboard? It's counterboard. Yeah, it's counterboard. So the diameter would be 38. The depth would be 13.5. And it's not a counterboard one, sorry, it's a simple one. It's simple. 30, yeah, I know. 38 and 13.5. Now for the position, select the face. And let's go for, if you move over here, you can snap onto the center and confirm. Looks good. Now I can go for the fillets. Let's start with 4 millimeter on this edge and that one. Confirm. Another fillet, 4 millimeter on this edge. Confirm. Now 5 millimeter on this one and that one. Let's go over here. Now for another 5. Here, confirm, and maybe 6 millimeter on this edge. Confirm. Now back to the top. Fillet 5 millimeter on this edge. Confirm. And the last one with 4 millimeter on this edge right here. Confirm. And I'm done. No, sorry, no, I'm not done. I have to do the shell. Sorry, so go for shell. That would be 1 millimeter. And I want to select tangency. And I want to remove that face as well. Confirm. And now I'm done. So hope you enjoyed this one. If you did, please give it a like or leave a comment. If you want to see more, please give it a like or leave a comment. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Please subscribe to my Facebook Catfin page. Would be very nice of you. I want to get more likes and subscriptions over there as well. Thanks for watching. See you to the next one. Bye bye.